first one running away. Now we're going to go inside this place and we're going to have a look and see who's all inside.
Hinten rechts sieht man Jürgen, Oberhaupt der Familie. Mike. Oh, Casey auch. Peter da schon.
Der ist schon wieder weg, der hat meinen Film vergessen.
So what party are you going to tonight?
We're going to Oma's 90th birthday.
I see.
Little child, maybe I was 10, and I had the inclination that these moving fish in these little aquariums is what I liked a lot. So somehow I did get a small aquarium, not more than maybe the size of two shoe cartons. All I had was an aquarium and cold water. That's all I had. The fish need light. So I got myself a very primitive lamp and put that over the aquarium. It made some sense, it worked. And then I needed heat. Now there it got out of hand. I put the aquarium on top of a stove. A very low heat. It's a small stove we had in the dining room, and I boiled the fish. I think a fish has more freedom than a dog or cat or a bird in a cage. I think this explains a lot. I want to let them do what they want to do.
This is what I mean. I'm neglecting it. I'm really neglecting it. The fish are all okay, the fish are okay. But it looks terrible because I don't have the time.
In the beginning it was very exciting, you know, even though we had no idea what we would do, but so with a little time here and there, we found it very interesting, and you know.
The war ended in Germany on my 14th birthday. And prior to my 14th birthday, you know, a child doesn't really care too much about freedom as long as you have something to eat.
It's still.
The air raid siren was on top of the store. The store was about three story high, and on top of that building, on the roof, was the siren. I recall I was in the store waiting to be served my milk, and I could hear the siren slowly rev up. Nobody could hear it outside the building, but in the building you could hear the siren getting going. And when it was going full blast, you better head home fast. A, it was very noisy, and B, you better get home before the before the planes, before the bombers come. Just have more than once. But you know, it's amazing how you get used to all these daily problems. If you were two air raids during the night, then we could go to school back in the morning. 1 hour later, they let us sleep in for 1 hour. When they say in today's world that the kids today, they need the school and all that because they get all kinds of mental problems, then I can only say, you don't know what it's all about. Because nobody ever asked us during the war about mental problems. The closest I personally got to the war, you won't believe it, was in the main railway station in Frankfurt in Germany. We were on the way back from Bavaria on a train. The train stayed in the railway station with hundreds and hundreds of children. The train, there were only kids on the train, and we stayed in the railway station. We all had to get out, go into a bunker under the railway station. Fortunately, the bombs missed the railway station. We were lucky. When the war ended, we were not supposed to be out on the street and blah, blah, blah. But all my friends knew that I had my 14th birthday. And guess what? They were all in our house to celebrate my birthday. That was the beginning of the better days. I'm trying to change. This is a December picture. I want to get a spring picture in here now. It's an old calendar. I have a new one, but I don't like to focus on the new one. Why did not hang straight?
He was very careful. No.
She was not even 17 yet. They have dad had said to her, watch out.
Yeah.
For that boy there. I chased her on the block. I met her during the school dance and asked her to meet me again a few days later after work in downtown Hamburg. And when I got there for that meeting in front of the opera house, dear Gisela was not there. I knew where she lived. I found her 2 days later in front of her own house. She was on the way to go to work and came out of her house and was now on the street, and I had been hiding behind a tree, and she walked towards the streetcar, and as the streetcar stopped, I jumped on the streetcar behind her.
Oh my God, that's crazy.
So you see, there was no escaping anymore. She could have jumped out of the streetcar, but she did not do that. I was the one who started the trip to Canada. But after we had been here for a few years, Oma liked it here better than I did.
That is something I was nosy about. I thought this was enormous. And I thought this was, you know, this was, oh, I was so excited about it. Mm-hmm. I think my father said to me, you look crazy.
I think she wanted to get away from all her aunts. She had too many aunts. She wanted to get away from her aunts. So what happened is, whenever we met them, they were all trying to figure out what are these two kids doing. One of them finally said, when are you going to get married? And Oma and I had not even talked about that part.
Are you taking pictures?
Smile, you're on candy camera.
A minor reason for going to Canada was freedom. That was a minor reason. We never had planned to stay here, by the way. You probably know that by now. After 3 years in Canada, I wanted to go back to Germany. I just wanted to get some experience in export commerce in Canada. That's why we went here, and we're still here. To broaden my education, that's why we came. And then we suddenly had a child, things changed. When we did arrive here, we knew nobody. We didn't know anybody. And all the people who came after us, Sydney, that you got to know, my sister Elfriede, my friend Gerd, all these other young people here, they all came after we came. So when they arrived here, I was in Toronto at Union Station and picked them up. But when I arrived, there was nobody to pick me up. I was all on my own. And I had a little spare money in my pocket for a return ticket to Germany in case I hated it here. But then, 10 weeks later, Oma arrived.
I remember the trip from Hamburg to here. And he was a baby. And I was, you know, they were all... He has to be out, a little fresh air, and they were so excited about it, you know, and helpful. Yeah, that was really nice, you know.
This all changed a bit. She had a good job. She got better pay than I did. She worked in a skyscraper in downtown Toronto.
Those were the good days.
The sun is going down, just coming up a bit, and then it goes down again.
Yeah, I'm now going outside, enjoy the sun for 20 minutes. I had a job. I had only one job in Canada, actually. I never had a second job. I loved what I did. I really enjoyed what I did. The company I worked for was importing high-precision German and Swiss machinery. We sold machines in all places. I did a lot of traveling. What happened is, I really felt I was getting overworked. I think, wait a minute now, what I did here, why don't I do this all for myself? Now, my boss, who I worked for at least 12 years, he didn't want me to leave. He wanted me to stay. I worked for him part-time for 2 years. And the other 2 years, I worked out of this house. In other words, it worked all very well.
Do you think you had more freedom working for yourself?
Yes. If you don't put the effort into it because there's nobody looking over your shoulder, you go broke. So, no, there's a 40-hour work week, and I kept that 40-hour work week for years and years when I had my own business. Do you remember how often I worked here for my own office in my own backyard here in summer? I said, these are the fringe benefits. I worked from my backyard calling customers. As a matter of fact, I called customers out of from beaches in Jamaica.
Wow.
Or Barbados. These are the fringe benefits. That's a benefit which you kind of did not expect, actually. I didn't expect that I could do that, that I could call customers in Toronto from standing in a sand beach in Barbados. That's a fringe benefit. or going home and visiting my parents on a business trip. Business trip, visiting your parents. That is the fringe benefit.
If I go back for the entire 90 years in retrospect, I think I was pretty lucky. I made it very well through the war, through the school, the Nazi areas. I was never in the army. I was quite a few times, I was quite sick. And the doctor sometimes said, surprise, I made it again. But all in all, sitting here, I don't think I'm very sick.
Happy birthday to you.
Make a wish. Think about it. Think about it.
Band, they have innovators, they have their own outdoor, arena.
Mm-hmm.
And we, when we were in Barbados, we danced to that band. God, was it expensive. Barbados is expensive anyway.
Ach Gott, ja.